before.
Fucking hell, yeah.
Yeah, I don't...
Nutters, yeah.
Could you explain, like, who they are and, like, what you discovered, like, whilst you were...
Yeah, so... Oh, man, asking about 09A. I'm going to sound like a nutcase now. So, as well as doing work, war and reporting, I often... war on conflict. So, let's start again. as well as covering war on conflict, I cover, like, extremist politics as well, because obviously a lot of extremists within politics become terrorists, become, you know, militants, whatever. It kind of goes hand in hand. So a few years back, I was looking into a neo-Nazi group called Atomwaffen and Division, essentially like you know, a neo-Nazi paramilitary group in America. They killed, I think, like 4 or 5 people in total. Where did that 09A come in? Yeah. So I was looking at them, and then all of a sudden I started seeing this weird, like, satanic iconography come into their like designs. And I recognised some of it because outside of my work, I'm fascinated with, like, weird, like, occult stuff. Not that I practice it or anything like that. I just find it interesting, you know, like cults and, like, weird kind of devil worship type stuff. Like, you know, all the, like, cheerful stuff, you know what I mean? So I was looking into it, and then I was like, hang on, I know that symbol. And basically, long story short, a satanic kind of occult group that started in England and believes in, like, human sacrifices had made its way somehow through the internet to a neo-Nazi group in America who took on their iconography and were like, right, we're like the paramilitary kind of neo-Nazi 09A force. 09A is Order of Nine Angles, it's weird. And this isn't like, you know, there's, you get all these satanic idiots. Every third podcast in Britain is, have you heard about this satanic paedophile ring? And 9 times out of 10, it's unfortunately masking a very real issue, but blowing it out of proportion with nonsense conspiracy stuff. But this one's real. Like, this is, Order of Nine Angles is, like, actually linked to murders, 2 human sacrifices in Russia last year, actually. So this is a real group. And I was like, wow, that's fascinating. And this Nazi group kind of took on 09A iconography. And some of them even kind of became more interested in the 09A than the Nazi stuff. And yeah, it's just this, the founder of it was, he was a former neo-Nazi terrorist. Then he converted to Islam and became an Islamist, like an extremist. He wrote a whole book about how great, like, Al-Qaeda is. Like, yeah, Osama bin Laden's cool, you know, like, he was really on it. Then he kind of stopped that and went into this weird, like, spiritual stuff. He's the guy that's behind it. He claims he's not. It's him. Everybody knows it's him. And yeah, like, he was linked to, like, the Brixton nail bombings. He's just a very weird guy, and now it's actually spreading. And there's kids as young as 13 and 14 have been convicted in Britain as being members of the 09A, or at least, well, they're not a prescribed organisation, so they're not convicted of being that, but they're convicted of the stuff that they've been involved with as a part of the 09A. And one of the darkest things is they get like girls, like young girls, to harm themselves, like self-harm, and they take images of it. And they're basically, their thing is, whatever is depraved, whatever is seen as fucked up by society, if we can indulge in that, we become, like, almost, like, not human anymore. Not physically, there's no physical change, but they become, like, desensitized to the point where they're like, right, we're just devil, evil, kind of, but, like, real evil, you know. It's a weird concept. It sounds like a conspiracy, it sounds like a nutcase, but it's real, you know. The fact that, to give you an idea of how real it is, the government right now in Britain is considering prescribing the 09A as a terror organisation. So they know it's real. There's been several attacks related to them. And yeah, it's just like, it's a rabbit hole, you know. It's the maddest rabbit hole I've ever been into. I'm fascinated by it, you know, really fascinated by it. And the thing is as well, they've got like thousands and thousands of pages of, like, books, like lore, like, you know, rituals. They have this mental game, it's like chess, but it's got like 5 different layers. It's called like the Stargate. Like, it's not just some idiot who's just spawned it on TikTok, you know. It's actually like loads and loads has gone into it, which is alluring for some people. For me, I'm like, fuck that. Like, it's mad, but it's mad. Yeah, it's mad. People love it though.